Newport, Oregon Public Library, and I'm here today with my friend Pongo. Let's call her name. Say Pongo. Hi, hi friends, I'm Pongo. Hi Pongo. Have you ever lost a mitten? Maybe. Maybe. Well, where do you think it goes when you lose your mitten?
I don't know. Maybe on an adventure?
Oh, maybe. Let's see what happens to Nikki's lost mitten in our story today, okay?
Okay, yay!
Once there was a boy named Nikki who wanted his new mittens made from wool as white as snow. At first, his grandmother Baba did not want to knit white mittens.
If you drop one in the snow, you'll never find it.
But Nikki wanted snow white mittens, and finally Baba made them. After she finished, she said, "When you come home, first I will look to see if you are safe and sound, but then I will look to see if you still have your snow white mittens." So off Nikki went, and it wasn't long until one of his new mittens dropped in the snow and was left behind. A mole, tired from tunneling along, discovered the mitten and burrowed inside. It was cozy and warm and just the right size. A snowshoe rabbit came hopping by. He stopped for a moment. Then he saw the mitten and he wriggled in feet first. The mole didn't think there was room for both of them, but when he saw the rabbit's big kickers, he moved over. Next, a hedgehog came snuffling along. Looking under wet leaves for something to eat, he decided to move into the mitten and warm himself. As soon as the hedgehog disappeared into the mitten, a big owl, attracted by the commotion, swooped down when he decided to move in also. The mole, the rabbit, and the hedgehog grumbled, but when they saw the owl's glinty talons, they quickly let him in. Up through the snow appeared a badger. He began to climb in. The mole, the rabbit, the hedgehog, and the owl were not pleased. There was no room left, but when they saw his diggers, they gave him the room. It started snowing, and a fox trotting by stopped to investigate. Just the sight of the cozy mitten made him feel drowsy, and the fox poked his muzzle in. When the animals saw his shiny teeth, they gave him lots of room. Then a great bear lumbered by. He began to nose his way in. The animals were packed in as tightly as could be, but what animal would argue with a bear? The mitten swelled and stretched. It was pulled and bulged to many times its size, but Baba's good knitting held fast. Along came a meadow mouse, no bigger than an acorn. She wriggled into the one space left and made herself comfortable on top of the great big bear's nose. The bear, tickled by the mouse's whiskers, gave an enormous sneeze. The force of the sneeze shot the mitten up into the sky and scattered the animals in all directions. On his way home, Nikki saw a white shape in the distance. It was the lost mitten. He ran to catch his snow-white mitten, and he saw Baba's face in the window. First, she looked to see if he was safe and sound, and then she saw that he still had his new white mittens. The end. Bless you. I'm the bear and I sneezed and the mitten went flying. It did. Wow. Well, we have to go back to the library now, Pongo. Can you say goodbye to your friends? Goodbye, friends. Goodbye. Goodbye, friends. We'll see you at the library.